Shall I start?
Yes.
Friends, most welcome to the third session of the day first of today in web conference organized by Shivaji Mahavidyalaya Udgir in collaboration with SRT Munition Nanded. Friends, pandemics are mass murderers. This is just like plague, smallpox, influenza, and cholera ruin families. Destroy towns and leave generations scarred and scarred. Since history, epidemics made a great effect on human life and the human race. Black Death, plague, Asian flu, swine flu, SARS, Zika virus are the name the few which affected human life at the large. It is being accepted globally that the present disaster of COVID-19 has originated from our reckless attitude toward wildlife and other environmental disasters. This devastation caused by outbreak also impacted many writers across the world. And literature has this great job to make men reflect over what he has done and what he can as well as has to do. A literary text, therefore, is the examination of human condition and metaphorical representation of pandemics. Pandemics often seem as a representation of God's curse, thus creates a sense of desolation subdued in dark environment. Possibility of disaster and technological advancement of pandemic can be seen in modern literary text. We need literature to guide us through the storm. And to highlight these issues with their authority and work, today in this session, we have wonderful resource person, Honorable Sri Gopal Baghel, a poet, spiritual writer, president of Akhil Vishwa Hindi Samiti and Spiritual Management Foundation, Toronto, ON, Canada, who will talk on the topic, understanding the role of literature in the time of crisis like corona pandemic to spiritual management technology and theory of microvita. We also have Dr. Amar Singh, professor and head, Department of English Government PG College, Chindwada, Madhya Pradesh, who will talk on topic, the resolutions of COVID-19 crisis and powerful ideas in our literature. And we have Dr. Kavar Dinesh Singh, Sahitya Akademi Awardee poet, author, translator, editor, and associate professor of English from Simla, Himachal Pradesh, to chair this session. I welcome you, Gopalji, Dr. Amar, and Dr. Dineshji. Sri Gopal Baghel, popularly known by his pen name as Madhu, is one of multi-faceted, multi-dimensional, distinguished persons born in Mathura, India, and now settled in Canada.
Right.
Who got translated of more than 7,000 poems and articles on spirituality and like topics in languages in Hindi, Braj, Sanskrit, Urdu, and English. He is the chairperson of All India Hindi Samiti. He was also on the powerful and strong contestant of an election of MP of Ontario State of Canada in 2011 election. He was president of International Hindi Committee, New Delhi, and is chairman of Madhu Publication Canada. He has 28 national international level awards to his credit. We are privileged to have these three gems, three icons today in this session. I will introduce Dr. Amar Singh and Dr. Kavar Dinesh at their turn. And now I request Sri Gopal Elias Madhu Ji to proceed for your talk or presentation. Dr. Baghel, please.
Namaskar. Thank you, Nawalaji, for a nice introduction. And I'm very grateful to not only Dr. Arvind Nawalaji, but Dr. Vinayak Jadavji, Kamal, and we are happy to have Dr. Kamal Kumar Dinesh Singh from Shimla. Okay, so we can go ahead now. Yes. The latest corona deaths worldwide, as per last record, are like total 4 lakhs worldwide, USA 1 lakh, UK 40,000, Brazil 32,000, Mexico 28,000, India 7,400, Canada 7,800. I will like to express on this, and so I like to say that literature is an expression from within while observing, understanding, coordinating, interacting, experiencing, analyzing, and realizing universe around us. It may be in any language, in form of music, or in any other subtle way. Hindi word sahitya is more comprehensive, which means sahe plus sahe plus hit. So that means the literature should be for everybody, and it should have a great flow, so that it benefits the whole of the humanity and the universe. Literature may be created or procreated through intuition, psychic and psychical spiritual flux, reading, conceptualizing, comprehension, and realization. It could appear mysterious, create mystery, or solve mystery. It may or may not be understood by at every level of mind. Now I will introduce spiritual management technology. So spirituality is basically the subjective experience of a sacred dimension and deepest values of living encounter with our own inner dimension, universal human experience connected to spirit or consciousness. Yoga to me is like a management, and tantra is a technology of management, that is tantra. According to cosmic cycle of creation of Mr. Pierre Sarkar, the universe itself is an internal thought projection of the cosmic mind. Flow of idea initiates creation. Non-expressed, expressed prakriti. Non-expressed becomes expressed. Nirguna Brahma becomes Sagun. And then it goes created. And then we have Mahat Aham Chitta. And after that, we have creation of Akash, ethereal factor, aerial factor, fire, liquid, and solid factor. And after that, again, when there is a collision in the solid factor, then we get the animals, we get the plants, animals, and then human being. And from there, we get intellectual human being, spiritual human being. And again, that entity merges into Saguna Brahma, or the expressed faculty, and then it may again turn into non-expressed one. Now I will introduce another factor, which is microvita. There is a theory of microvita. And on 31st December 1986, the great spiritual master and philosopher, Sri Pierre Sarkar, Sri Sri Anand Murthyji, introduced a new concept. Fortunately, I was part of this audience in a remote spiritual environment in West Bengal, India. He said the mysterious, there is a mysterious emanation of cosmic factor, and that he defined as a microvita. Now, this microvita is the plural of microvitam, and they are living entities within the scope of both physical and psychic expression. They are subtler than atoms or electrons, or whatever particles we may research further. In psychic realm, they may be subtler than ectoplasm. Microvita are neither electrons nor ectoplasm, but are just in between. They are mysterious because their characteristics are not known to us. There are three levels of subtlety of microvita. The least subtle can be seen by powerful microscope, and we call it virus. Virus is a vague term, and microvitam is the better term. The next subtle level of microvitam comes within the scope of perception, not directly, but as a result of their external expression or external faculty. The subtlest level of microvitam can only be perceived by a special type of perception, which is actually the reflection of conception within the periphery of perception. This special type of perception can only be felt by persons having highly developed spirituality oriented minds. Microvita move throughout entire universe. Their movement is not restricted by temperature or pressure like living beings. They exist, multiply, and die. They move through one or many media at once. They can move through sound, touch, taste, textuality, form, and smell. Microvita exists as collective or individual structure. These collective structures can have both positive and negative effects on human minds. They cannot be created or emanated by human beings. we shall have to develop new ethics while enhancing positive metadata, which will lead to multilateral salvation of human society, will remove economic exploitation, political separation, religious indoctrination, cultural imposition, and social subordination. Microbiota can be positive or negative or neutral. Rudest microbiota occupy subtlest level of physical space. The next subtler microbiota occupy psychic space, and the subtlest occupy suprapsychic space. As they are creation of cosmic mind, they don't function in spiritual level. Positive microbiota start their action on similar plexus and can move up or down the other plexus. Negative microbiota normally cannot move above physicist psychic plexus and move only downwards. A person doing a spiritual meditation cannot be attacked by negative microbiota. Even positive microbiota cannot reach up to multi-propensity plexus. One needs help of a great personality or supreme consciousness for that, and must do spiritual sadhana or meditation. Human beings should take up help of positive microbiota to control depraving effect of negative effect of microbiota dominating the whole world today. And I'll summarize, because we don't have much time, probably a few minutes or more. Now, positive ideas carry positive or friendly microbiota, whereas negative idea or thought attracts negative microbiota. These microbiota maintain the balance of the expressed creation. Extreme negativity attracts negative microbiota and creates new diseases. So is coronavirus the outcome of a negative outlook and acute crudity or unimaginable negativity. The origin of coronavirus supports this idea. It originated in a place where all types of animals are killed mercilessly to fulfill human greed. The way this virus is being spread also supports the intuition idea of Sri Anandamurtiji. The whole world is afraid. Day by day, the number of deaths is increasing and thousands of people are being affected. Perhaps, not surprisingly, P.R. Sarkar's advice, especially for meditators, is meditation. A deeper level of mental absorption, also explained as an uninterrupted flow of memory, as the remedy against negative microbiota. This concept correlates the correction in between literature and COVID-19 in my mind. While the literature is positive microbiota, corona or any other virus are negative microbiota. Positive microbiota could be Gandharva, Yaksh, Kendra, Siddha, and literature could be part of expression of Gandharva. Negative microbiota could be a virus which may adversely affect whole planet or cosmos. A balance is maintained by interaction of positive and negative microbiota. We need to increase and enhance positive microbiota to take care of negative microbiota. It is like a battle of Mahabharata or Mahavishwa, which is to be commanded and controlled by a spiritual director, Krishna. As current Kauravas are infinite times more talented and powerful, with the available resources of Prakriti, present Pandavas in guidance of current Krishna must be even much more vigilant, vibrant, remotely active, actuator, motivator, director, or cosmic controller. We must enhance and advance our literature, arts, dances, music, meditation, yoga, yantra, tantra, science, technology, or organizational administrators, socio-economic and political management, global coordination, and cosmic interaction. Without interacting our individual entities to cosmic entity, we may not be able to maintain equipoise and equilibrium, which we call prama. A poet, writer, singer, musician, painter, or artist through creation or composition may vibrate or articulate physical, psychic, social, political, or spiritual entities at any place, at any time. Okay, so namaskar with that.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Yeah.
Our and thank to be bright, because we have a very jumbo session after this session. Our second speaker, Dr. Amar Singh, is a professor and head department of English and placement officer, personality development trainer at Government Autonomous PG Led College, Chindwada, Madhya Pradesh. He is a member of the board of studies of Dr. H.S. Gaur Central University, Sagar, MP. He is MP higher education trained motivator on personality development, communication skills, and self-empowerment training. The government of Madhya Pradesh conferred upon him Akshar Mitra Award for his literary contribution and declared him as an icon of Chindwara district for best election trainer under SVIIP, SWIP plan of Election Commission of India. Dr. Amar Singh, I request you your talk or presentation, but I request you to be brief. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank yes, sir.
Yes, please, Dr. Amar.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, yes, sure, sure, pakka.
Audible and visible both?
Yes, both visible and audible. Yeah.
Yes, yes, yes. You're welcome, sir.
Thanks a lot, Dr. Arvind ji, for providing me this very rare opportunity to put my thoughts, literary thoughts, on how to handle this COVID-19 tragedy. My dear friends, first of all, we should understand what actually the crisis leaves behind, the lessons of life. Crisis teaches us what we are and what we can be. So the gap between what we are and what we can only be filled by the crisis. So this is the positive opportunity of the crisis. Perhaps, certainly we often complain against the natural things, but it is said that the fault is not in our stars, the fault lies in us. So let us explore ourselves, our faults, and only then we can resolve this very tragedy. I would also like to define what actually life is. Life is a tale, according to William Shakespeare. Life is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. There is nothing realistic behind life. Everything is elusive. Life is what we think of it, we give to it. My dear friends, where our knowledge ends, let us understand the nature of the nature. That is God also, the sole controller of this very universe. Let us understand it. Where our knowledge ends, the world of nature begins. So what happens in the world of nature, we should accept it as a reality and adjust ourselves according to it. Time, we should also understand what is the significance of time, what is the relativity of time and nature. Time has its own will. It executes its planning without considering what are its consequences. Its execution is timely. Nothing is irrelevant in time. It's our lack of understanding that we react otherwise. So we should at least, it least cares for us. Time least cares for us. We are weak, no problem. We are feeble and we are impotent also against these forces of nature. But struggle is our birthright for our survival. Hope can do wonders in this struggle. We get what we deserve. We get, my dear friends, we get what we deserve. The good has its own consequences also. On several times we think that we have done something evil, that's why we are being punished by this very COVID-19. The good has its own consequences also. We should understand this very philosophical thought. Only then we can resolve and come out of this very tragedy. Wrong people, there is a very good lesson from wrong people and wrong events also. Somebody has said that wrong people and fatal circumstances leave behind life learning lessons. So is the case with this very tragedy also. It is also leaving behind some very life learning lessons of life. My dear friends, nature is balancing itself. It never allows its tempering. We human beings have tempered this very nature. That's why we are being punished. Don't disturb the natural equilibrium. Human greed and capitalist approach has led us to such predicament. Man learns through tragedies, my dear friends. This tragedy is nature's manifestation. Aggression of nature destroys everything. Ultimately, the nature emerges the winner. We fight and fight against it. We human beings should understand this bitter thing also, that on this very earth, we are as custodians of this earth. Let us, we take a pledge not to make it this earth a filthy one. Our religious scriptures underline this very thing, underline the significance of relation between nature and us. Vedas, Upanishads, Buddhism, Jainism, all the religious scriptures have taught us these very lessons. Even Coleridge also says that nature loveth those who love both great and small. It dispenses nature. Nature gives the ultimate justice to human beings. In Mary Shelley's novel, Frankenstein, where the theme is that wherein the creature destroys the creator. Rousseau also propounds how nature imparts human beings and how it justifies the things. My dear friends, we will understand, once we understand the nature, life will smile again. Man can't conquer nature. We should understand this thing seriously. This world depends on mutual cooperation, mutual coexistence, and mutual understanding between human beings and nature also. The principle of karma, without expecting results, can give wonders to we human beings. The principle of karma foregrounds the importance of good actions, that is sadkarma. Our attachment towards things prevents us from good deeds also. At several places, William Shakespeare has also written that the fair is foul and foul is fair. The things which we appear good may appear evil also. All that glitters is not gold. The appearances are always deceptive. We are such stuff, my dear friends. We are such stuff as dreams are made of. And our little life is rounded with a sleep. The one more lesson that this tragedy can teach us that we have enjoyed our nature violently. So the violent delights have violent ends also. So let us be prepared, because we have exploited this nature to the extreme, to any excesses. So these violent delights have violent ends. Let us face it happily, without any grudge. The inward journey can make us powerful. In these circumstances, my dear friends, let us start our inward journey, because outward journey is deceptive. It is not going to work anymore. Let us enter the world of spirituality, and we can have permanent solution of this very tragedy there. The virus has shattered the taken for granted the world. We people have unknowingly, unintentionally, or maybe under any conspiracy, we have taken this world for granted. The things are not at all so. The nature has its own rules and regulations. Where the extent of our knowledge ends, the world of nature begins. Literature gives life. Our literature can give us life-affirming values. So let us search the life-affirming values in our literature. It has awakened. This very tragedy has awakened our collective consciousness. that remained dormant for long. We are now awakened as life is the name of new discoveries. My dear friends, we have to discover new things, experience, invent, explore, struggle, and life is the key solution to life. As Tennyson has also once said in his poem Ulysses, we have to strive, to seek, to find, and not to yield. Live life to the least. We people were living incomplete life. So we have to live our life to the least, to fully. We have to give our excellent form. How dull it is to pause. Although this tragedy is challenging us to pause, to stop the human actions, but we are not going to stop anymore. How dull it is to pause, make an end, rust unvarnished, and not to sign in use. Milton can also help in this regard during this very tragedy also. The tragedy is in our thinking, not in real life. The mind is its own place and in itself can make heaven of hell and hell of heaven. It is our thinking. There is nothing either good or bad in this world. Our thinking makes it so. So let us think it in the right and positive manner. Negative thoughts are not going to work anymore. Here, Robert Browning can also help us, guide us philosophically. I was ever a fighter. We all human beings have to fight together this very tragedy. I was ever a fighter, so one fight more, the best and the last. The best is yet to be. The best is yet to be. My dear friends, things are never as bad as they seem outwardly. We have to see the things inwardly also, intuitively also, philosophically also. The message of helping the needy. We have been the persons of our Indian culture. I am nijay paro vet gadna lag chet sam. Udar charitanantu vasudhaiv kutumkam. The whole universe is our family. So we have to hold the whole universe as a whole. The message of the nature is quite clear that let us help the needy in this very time. Otherwise, the gap between the higher and the lower people were huge. So nature is filling that very gap, the gap between the rich and the poor, the gap between the king and the lower status, that is being filled. All human beings are equal. Nobody belongs to the higher rank. And one thing more, my dear friends, we should understand, on this very earth, we are only tourists. We are only guests on this earth, not possessors or owners. We have unnecessarily possessed the things. We have declared its owners. That's why we are facing the tragedy. The woods are lovely, dark, and deep. We have to believe in Robert Frost's philosophy that earth is the right place to love. I don't know where else to go for it. This earth is for love, for mutual trust, for mutual faith. The woods, the whole nature is lovely. The woods are lovely, dark, and deep. But I have promises to keep, miles to go before I sleep, miles to go before I sleep. This world is also a beautiful world to enjoy in its own manner, as a guest also, a thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases, it will never pass into nothingness, but it keeps us a bower quite for us. Milton also, we have to resolve, we have to show determination, perseverance, willpower to resolve this very tragedy. We are not going to be defeated this very. We have been defeating other tragedies during hundreds of years in the past also. So we will defeat this very tragedy also. Let us speak in Milton's term. What though the field be lost, all is not lost. The unconquerable will and the study of revenge and hate and courage never to submit. We are not going to submit or surrender against this very tragedy. Some other poet has also said in Hindi, Jid hi sid hai. We are stubborn, we are adamant to win over this very tragedy. We have to develop out of box thinking and we will resolve this very tragedy. We have to leave the comfort zone of our, we have to face the challenges. Let us be focused and let us be focused on solution instead of on problems. Patience, we have to prepare and prevent this. We have to prepare for this tragedy and prevent this very tragedy rather than repair and repent over this very tragedy. Never give up attitude. This is high time we develop never give up attitude. Discipline, determination and dedication is the our soul mantra to resolve this very tragedy. We are never too old to get a new goal of life, to dream a new dream. Let us make tragedies our teachings of life. In life, life is a journey. Life is not a destination. Life is rising after every fall. When we fall 10 times and when we get up 11 times, that is the definition of human beings. We have to work hard and we have to stay grounded. We have to give 100%, give our best and emerge as excellent. In the end, I would like to that there are objective messages of this very tragedy. We can conclude the things in this way. Life is unpredictable, friends. Don't take time for granted. Open your eyes to opportunities. Help find purpose of life. Let us explore the real purpose of life. Test of our in this tragedy is the test of our inner strength. Bring out the best in ourselves. It strengthens human bond. Tragedies strengthen human bond. It is an awakening period. Fix priority. We human beings have to fix priority. We have to do revaluation of our dedication to material pursuits of life also. Service is our satisfaction. Sense of gratitude is the thing. The greatest friendship, it is the time that we develop universal friendship. Some poets have also said that scars are also beautiful. So let us search the beauty in the scars also. Be kind, we have to kind unconditionally. Equality prevails everywhere, my dear friends. Spirituality is the new world order. Let us have faith in it. We discover the best in ourselves. We have to use limited resources for maximum achievements. We have to make us grounded and rooted also. Troubling past makes for bright future also. This tragedy is not going to break our faith. We are going to break this very tragedy and we are going to break our records also. We have to learn to face the problems of life. Risk taking becomes the new order of the day. Strength grows when we dare. This is the time to show our leadership. The leader is that who knows the direction of the wind in advance. Life is full of challenges. We have to do a massive doings. We have to emerge as massive doer, massive thinkers, and massive results will come. That will be our success in the end. Experience of solving the problems is the new thing. Golden opportunities are hidden in ruins also. We have to emerge as new masterpiece figures of this very universe because adversities inspire us to break our own requests. Let us have our revaluation of time, rare life, rare action. Life becomes more meaningful. This very tragedy is emergence of new barriers. So we people have to emerge as new barriers of higher education, as professors with self-confidence, courage, valor. We have to emerge fighters. We have to realize ourselves. We have to establish our own identity. We are not going to emerge quartz of life. Discovery of powerful ideas can only solve this very problem and such nuisance also. So we have to go to the roots of our literature, our Puranic literature, our scriptures, and we will find all the solutions of life there. Thank you. Thanks a lot. So nice of you for listening to me. Thanks, Navli.
Thank you, Dr. Amar Singh. Now there are some questions for Baghel ji and Amar ji.
Yes.
I am taking them to.
Yes.
I am just allowing them to ask online. One, okay. Allow to talk. Dr. Ladda, Ekta Ladda. Dr. Ekta Ladda, ask your question, please. Unmute your mic. Even you can on your video. It is up to your choice. Ask your question.
Sir, I want to ask that while translating some text, there are some words.
Introduce yourself, means you are from which institution, and then ask your question. And your question is from whom you expect answer, from Gopalji Baghel or from Dr. Amar
Singh? Yes, sir.
In fact, all these three people are related to translation, okay, and they are bilingual, okay.
Anyone can answer
question with Varu and authority. You desire, just make your video on. Okay, it is up to you. You may talk also without video on also. Ask question. Sir, ask your question.
The question may be answered by anyone, but my question is this only, that while translating one text from one language to another, certain words that are specific in that language cannot be converted or translated exactly. So the meaning somewhere gets lost. So how to cover up that thing?
Your question is concerned with how to translate without losing its root meaning. You all are the translators. Amar Singh, you reply.
Yes, sir.
You may reply, and at last, Dr. Kavar will cover in his presiding over.
Yes, Dr. Baghel sir will answer. Hai na?
Yeah. Dr. Baghel sir, how to, her question is how to translate any text from source language to target language without losing its true and the root, the basic meaning. Unmute your mic. Your mic is, Baghelji, your mic is mute. Unmute it.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. So basically, we can translate by computer, and then whatever it is coming, then we have to apply our mind. And so the translator, he has to bridge the gap, you know, he has to make exactly what is expressed in one language to another. And that is what translator is doing. That is the job of translator. Because by machine or computer, we are just translating mechanically. Whatever it comes, then we have to modify it. And we have to improve. That is where the role of translator is.
Is it okay?
Sir, but in certain cases, the computer is also not able to respond to that words. Like in Hindi, we have garma garam chai. So while translating in the that language, we cannot have exact meaning. So somewhere the sense is lost.
We have to improve the software in that case. But my practical experience is even the Google Translate, it is giving much better translation. Then you have to try different softwares. So you have to choose one which is best, and then you have to apply your mind.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Yeah.
There is one more question from 1 minute. Sumantha Rajbansi. Okay. Sumantha ji.
Namaskar, sir.
Please ask. You may on your video also ask your question.
Namaskar, sir.
Yeah, namaskar. Ask your
sir,
question.
What lesson can we draw from the present pandemic situation and all the sufferings and the ordeals and predicaments that it entails? And that's my question, sir.
Amar Singh, it is to you. It is addressed to
yes,
you.
Sir.
Yes, my dear friends, all the tragedies leave behind its very strict lessons, eye-opening lessons of life. I have already counted many things. Again, once I want to remind that tragedies are also hidden opportunities, blessings in disguise. It depends upon our thinking, how we take them for here. If our attitude is problematic, we are having negative attitude, we will start weeping, crying over it. But in these times also, many new things are happening. many new things are breaking the records. Many, we can take the example of that very one girl who started cycling with his father from Gurgaon to Bihar. She has broken the record. She has. Otherwise, the positive circumstances, these records never happen. So we have to give our, we only give our 100% only when we face the challenges, we are fearful. Otherwise, we live our good life. We only take out our better and best things when we are challenged. It is also said that man gives his best only when he is pulled and pushed. So that is my answer, my dear.
There is one more question from Prabharati Sen from Government PG College, Narsingpur, MP. I am taking her here on screen, but she is not online, I think. Okay, we will discuss question. Question is like this. Yes. What can we learn from the pandemic literature of the past and apply it on the present COVID-19 scenario? It is from Prabharati Sen, Assistant Professor, Government PG College, Narsingpur, MP.
Yes.
I would like
my
to
dear repeat. Friend.
Amar Singh, you can see. You can see your, the question on your panel also. Okay.
Yes, sir. Right. Yes. Sir, the past ill or past is always history. Why do we study history? We do study history because past events teach us strict lessons. They give us warnings also, what to do, what not to do. And if somebody repeats the past mistakes, he is called fool. So the vibration of the past, the vitality of past comes into the present. So the lessons of the past tragedies, we can learn from them. We can study the past literature in the context of tragedies, and those lessons can work in present also. So the history is full of past events and tragedies and casualties. That's why that is the significance of history and historical literature also. You know? That's my answer, my dear sir.
There is one more question from Ruchi Tomar. Ruchi?
Yes, sir.
Come online, make your video
visible. Yes, sir. This is a question for Professor Amar Singh.
Make your video visible.
Sir,
yes,
okay,
Ruchi.
Let me see.
If it is possible to you, there will
yes,
be live.
Yes, it is possible, but I'm trying that way is the camera.
Yeah. If it is possible, otherwise you may ask through audio, no problem.
You may ask the question, no problem.
Yeah.
Okay. Sir, I would like to know from Amar Singh, sir, that what pandemic crisis one can get in literary text. Means I want to ask that what sort of pandemic characteristics that we can see in literary text. Please give some examples from the text to understand it properly.
Yes, you just ask your question once more. You know? I'm not able to get it.
Ruchi, please repeat your question.
Sir, I'm asking that what sort of pandemic characteristics we can get in literary text.
Dr. Amar Singh, you want to know that
yes, sir.
How the pandemic crisis are projected in text, and you want example of any text, okay, for understanding. The plague, there are hundreds of texts, Ruchi. Okay, Amar, you replied.
Yes, sir.
To know the end of the text. Unmute, Amar Singh, unmute your mic. Amar Singh, unmute your mic. Amar Singh, unmute your mic. Okay, Ruchi, I think that he is not getting.
Okay, sir. No.
Okay.
No problem.
Okay. I'm giving us the number of the texts are there. Okay, right from the
return.
Numbers, Iliads. Okay.
Hello.
Yeah. Amar Singh, yeah.
All the, yes, sir. Whatever tragedy we face, our soul becomes the noble one. We emerge more purified person, more strengthened and powerful person. So we should study, just for example, example of Columbus. In a poem I have studied about Columbus, that during the last 3 days of his discovery, all the sailors, his companion sailors, were torturing him. They threatened him to kill him. But Columbus told them that we have to move ahead. Otherwise, it will take 6 months to return to your houses. So after 3 days, you should kill me. So on this very pretext, they continued their journey for 3 days and they discovered the new world. So that is the challenge. In this way, we learn the things here. Challenges teach us, tragedies teach us many things also. That's why T.S. Eliot also said that those who don't want to suffer life, those who don't want to struggle in life, those who don't want to bear odds in life, they should not come to this very world. But this is not in our hand to come to this very world. Once we get this very life, all the good lessons come from life. Tragedies make us powerful, it is said, and comedies make us weaker human beings also.
It is okay.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Alka Agarwal.
Okay.
To talk. Dr. Agarwal, ask your question. Dr. Alka Agarwal. Okay, I think that technical problem is with her. Yes. I will ask her question. She is asking, she wrote, the culture and feel of the writer's hurt and environment. Dr. Alka Agarwal is renowned, she's an associate professor. Can translation, I think that Bagelji can answer it anywhere, Dr. Dinesh can answer it with more verve, as they have a lot of experience of translation. The question, can translation work present the culture and feel of the writer's hurt and environment? Obviously.
Dr. Dinesh should answer this very question.
Dinesh is about to preside. He will cover it. Okay, and Alka is, I think that she is not online. The question, okay. Dr. Dinesh will cover. Let me turn to end of this session. Now, yeah. Now it's turn of Dr. Dinesh. Okay, and let me. Dr. Dinesh, Comrade Dinesh Singh, who is chairing this third plenary session, is equally extraordinary literary personality, associate professor of English in Simla, Himachal Pradesh. He is a recipient of 2002 Sahitya Akademi Award and some other equally prestigious literary honors for his contribution to poetry in particular and overall literature in general, by Government of Himachal. Long back when I was in Simla, Dinesh gave me his, some of the books, which still I have in my personal library. Till date, he has 15 books of poetry in English, 11 volumes of poetry in Hindi, and 8 books on literary criticism. Besides this, 60 papers, reviews, chapters are to his credit. He is also editor of Hyphen, a prestigious international print literary journal. Have been prescribed for UG and PUG level syllabus as a textbook at several universities, not only of India, but also in abroad, including NCK University, Taiwan. Dr. Dinesh, kindly make your comments on both talks. Also cover the question raised by the participants and preside over the session. Dr. Dinesh Kumar Singh, please.
Thank you very much, Dr. Navle. I have only 10 minutes, so I would like to sum up the things in within the time. First of all, I would like to thank and congratulate the two luminaries, Shri Gopal Baghel ji and Dr. Amar Singh ji, for their wonderful presentations. Both the scholars have conveyed significant ideas for dealing with the ongoing crisis on account of the COVID-19 pandemic across the world. Each has offered a workable stratagem for combating the coronavirus in the best possible way as per their chosen areas of study. Mr. Gopal Baghel's presentation relies on the scientific and spiritual basis of microbes, which is surely full of hope and potential, while referring to P.C. Sarkar's concept of positive, negative, and neutral microbiota as the very foundation of any physical and psychic structure, and as the smallest and elementary particles of matter, and as the source of vital energy, as well as a psychic world, he has very aptly linked them to the current crisis created by coronavirus. Although his institutional science of microvita has been probed into by some scientists in Europe, I hope present and coming generation of researchers and scientists will take a cue from this concept and put it to the use and benefit of the humankind. Second presentation was by Dr. Amar Singh. His presentation very eloquently addresses the impact of the nature's fury, such as coronavirus, on the human world, especially the psychological effect, creating problems for the mental health of people. He has very pertinently defined the bond between nature and man. His conceptualization about the nature's wrath as the cause of tragedy in the human world, and about the use of scriptures and literary texts in the times of COVID-19 pandemic opens the windows to the researchers to further study how literature can be used as a potent strategy to cope with the negative impact of the pandemic on the human mind. Dr. Singh's instances from literary texts have been wonderful. His optimism is remarkable. Both the presenters deserve kudos for their valuable inputs. I congratulate both of them for their enlightening talks. Now, as regards the questions, there were two questions regarding translation, and the problem of translating the text from one language to another with all the nuances of culture and language. So the question was by Ekta Ladha and Madam Alka. So I think if they are on.
See Dinesh, in Q&A. In Q&A, questions are visible till.
Yes.
Dr. Dinesh, click on Q&A.
Okay.
You can watch, you can read their questions. Sir.
No, I can't.
Q&A, click on it. I think that it is Alka Rani Agarwal's question. And she has texted here that.
Okay. I'll just.
Yeah. Sixth number question.
I would like to comment about that. So about that question. Yes, about that question. As Robert Frost had said, poetry is what is lost in translation. Poetry is what is lost in translation. So he was very right in saying that actually the translation is never literal. It is never literally done. There is always a problem of finding words equivalent to the words in the source language. So to cope with that problem, sometimes we have to use the words of the source language as such. Like I did some translations. There I found the Durva. Durva is the name of a sacred grass in India. So I could not find proper word for that. I used the same as such in the English text, Durva, duly italicized. So we can use the words which do not have equivalent words in other language as such. So the other question that can culture be translated? So that is really a very difficult task. We can't translate culture from one language to another language. Every language has its own soul, its own culture behind it. So I think it's a very broad topic to be covered here. So translation requires a lot of effort, a lot of hard work, a lot of toiling. So that's the problems associated with translation. So I thank all the participants in this session. And finally, I thank, commend, and congratulate the webinar convener, Dr. Arvind Navle, for his sincere efforts in organizing this webinar in an efficient manner. I'm grateful to him for giving me the opportunity to be a part of this important event. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Dinesh.
Thank you
for wonderful delivery.
If we have...
your comments on the both the talks of resource persons, as well as you covered the question, some of the questions. There are some technical problems for them to mute and unmute the mic. That's why that was difficult for them to come here, to appear here.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Still have
all of you, Dr. Bagilji, and thank you. Dr. Bagilji, it is being telecasted on YouTube. Okay. Yeah, you may watch it on YouTube. And Amar Singh, for making this evening. There is a morning in Canada, but you spare a time for us. And I'm top of Shivaji College in the Department of English and KSP Mandal and SRTM University. And I'm closing now this meeting. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.
Thanks a lot. So nice of you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.